Contestant number one, you guys make some noise. Say Clubwear. This is Clubwear and question and answer. Please make some noise for contestant number one, Arthur. They want to ask the question for you. Oh, look at that. All right, Arthur, come here and pick. In my hands, I hold numbers, which represents all seven of the judges, which I didn't introduce the other half of the collect, because Collectus is being kind of a little bit of a cunt. So, anyway, you are going to choose a number right now, and whichever judge you choose is going to ask you a question. Got it? It's like real simple. And Arthur has chosen judge number six. Judge number six. Is judge number six Jenna? Yay, Jenna! And you guys, I promise you, you're gonna hear more from Jenna in just a second. She's gonna perform for us and she's gonna talk. So Jenna.
Actually,
you
were six.
I'm seven.
Since we have one mic. Jenna, what is your question?
I apologize in advance. I'm a dude! What the fuck?
Is that right?
I didn't even tuck tonight, that's why I wore this poodle skirt. My junk is all kinds of flapping in the wind. Anyway, I'm sorry. We are fortunate enough to live in a day and age where we are not persecuted necessarily for our sexuality. Yet, we seem more preoccupied now with being masculine or straight acting. What are your thoughts on this and how has it affected our community?
Would you repeat the question?
We're fortunate enough to live in a day and age where we're not necessarily persecuted for being homosexuals. However, we seem preoccupied these days with being masculine over feminine or straight acting. What are your thoughts on that and how has it affected our community?
Jesus Christ. Chris, I'll have an Adderall if you need.
And here with the answers, contestant number one, Arthur.
I've always felt that the feminine.
Put it up, close to your face.
I've always felt that when a gay guy likes a straighter guy or anything in that manner, it leads them to straight guys. And it ruins relationships, and that's what I believe being gay is looked down upon, and moral-wise. But, I mean, it has ruined our outlook on being gay, period. So.
You guys, contestant number one, Arthur! Yay! Arthur! Oh my god. That was fun. Do we need to bring them all out again together? Can they just go and change? Yeah.
Yeah.
You can go and shit now, Arthur. Okay. Here we go. Contestant number two, please make some noise for Jake.
I'm
good. I'm Gucci. Now you can kiss your old dude goodbye. Smooch your shirt, bitch. You're a beauty. Man, I think somebody didn't get Cupid a Uzi. Shoot me, you're a firework. Lighter in the dark. So let's turn off the lights and give me that spark.
Facebook your ass later, honey, okay? Alright, here we go. Right now, pick a judge, honey. You got judge number three.
Lane.
You're judge number three? You have judge number three, Lane. Alright, here we go.
Jake, my question for you is, if you were to win the title of Mr. Rainbow here tonight, what would you consider to be the biggest obstacle to becoming prepared for a competition in Ohio?
All right, and just a little bit louder, Lane, please, so everyone can hear. You guys, did y'all hear him? No? Okay, just a little bit louder, Lane, and slow it down, please.
If you were to win the title of Mr. Rainbow tonight, what would you consider the biggest obstacle in preparing yourself for the competition in Ohio?
In here for your answers, contestant number two, Jake.
Well, there's gonna be a lot of obstacles, obviously, like a bigger crowd and like a just a bigger environment, but I feel like the biggest obstacle for me is trying not to let this get to my head, trying not to overthink things. Because when I'm there, I don't want to have to like overthink things and mess up and stuff like that. So that would be my biggest obstacle.
You guys, contestant number two, Jake! Yes! Jake needs to have his dick set. I'm just saying. Is he right to say like me? So Jake needs his dick set for you. Tyson, number three, are you ready? Here we go, Tyson!
You're looking very handsome this evening, young man. Okay, would you like to choose a judge?
Ooh. Oh wait, that was Alexis that fell on the floor.
And he has contestant number seven, I mean judge number seven. Judge number seven. Who is judge number seven? That's you? All right, here we go.
Back. Another question.
Come on, please.
Don't steal a soul.
Why'd you feel it necessary?
Why do you feel that it was necessary for you to be a part of this competition? And what will you do if you advance?
All right, and we're going to repeat the question, and we're going to say it louder and with more English.
Because you love English. Because you got nice boobies.
Why did it feel that it was necessary for you to be a part of this competition, and how will you feel if you advance?
Very good question.
Contestant number three, Tyson.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I promise to come a little closer so you can hear the sincerity in my words.
Closer.
The reason why I came to compete tonight is because it's absolutely necessary to show people that if you can do anything that you want to do when you put your mind to it and put your heart to it. It doesn't matter whether you're black, white, it doesn't matter whether you're fat or skinny, it doesn't matter if you're burned, have scars or marred. If you have confidence in yourself, you can do it. If I were to advance, I would do everything that I possibly could to represent Fort Worth and represent the Rainbow Lounge as best as I could. Thank you.
Thank you, Tyson. That was contestant number three, Tyson. Yes. Contestant number three, Tyson. All right, Jen, are you going to change? So look, lucky me, I have more time to waste. I'm so excited. You guys, I didn't get to finish introducing the judges. I was stuck right here in the middle with Calexis Davenport, which I gotta tell you guys, she's one of my very, very dear friends. Her and I have worked together at the Rose Room in Dallas for many, many years. We both work over there, and we're both hookers. I say that, I'm kidding. We're really not hookers. We are. We really are. I love this young lady. Okay, but Calexis just told me, she said that she doesn't like it that her question didn't get to get asked. So she's going to ask me her question. Okay, whether or not I'm going to fucking answer this bullshit, I don't know.
You'll do it!
I don't have to do anything.
You do.
I don't want to do. I'm a grown ass fucking man. I don't have to do anything. Here we go. Yeah, I'm kidding. I can't believe I even just said that. I'm a grown ass one. Here we go. Calexis, what is your question?
Grown ass man. My question to you is serious pageant mode.
I love it.
If an orange is called an orange, why is a banana not called a yellow? In question and answer, she's Crystal Summers, contestant number the loser.
Because yellow is called Kyle, and that's why.
If an orange is called an orange, why is a banana not called a yellow?
Because it's called Kyle.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, in regards to the question from Calexis Davenport, judge, head judge, number, whatever. Why an orange is called an orange and why a banana is not called yellow? It is because the banana simply does not want to be fucking called yellow. That is why. Ladies and gentlemen, for your approval, I'm contestant.